So, you're considering making a move to Melbourne, Florida, and you're wondering what the cost of living is, and more importantly, you're wondering how it's going to affect your wallet. Well, in this video, we're going to cover just that, and let me tell you, things have definitely changed, so make sure you stick around to the end. My name is Rachel Langley with Florida Lifestyle Realty, right here in Brevard County. If you want to know what it's like to eat, sleep, live, and play in the Space Coast, make sure to hit the subscribe button so you get notified every time I post a new video. We are getting calls all the time from people just like you relocating here, and we absolutely love it. So if you are thinking or planning to move here, make sure to reach out anytime via text, phone, email, and we'll get back to you as soon as possible. Well, in today's video, we're going to get into the cost of living. I know this isn't news to anyone, whether you're living in Michigan, New York, San Diego, Toronto, wherever it is, all of our cost of living has increased dramatically over the past 2 years. We've all been dealing with the inflation, and we've all seen housing prices hit record highs. What I wanted to do today is give you an update here in Melbourne, Florida. Whether you have your eyes set on Melbourne or surrounding areas, this will help you wrap your mind around what it is like to live in the Melbourne area. So, let's get right into the top 5 costs. Over the last couple of years, we've been using a website called bestplaces.net, and I'll put the link to it down below. That way you can have access to it. What the website does is it takes a large group of metropolitan areas and really starts to define what it costs to live there. What I'm going to do today is I'm going to share the stats from the website, and I'm also going to share my personal expenses with you guys so you can wrap your head around what it's like to live here. And I know it can be hard because, let's face it, some people are overspenders and some people are great at budgeting. So the 5 categories we have today are groceries, housing, utilities, transportation, and insurance. Number 1, let's talk about groceries because things are getting really expensive. And I know that everyone is experiencing this because we've got family back home in Rhode Island. We've got friends and family all over the country, and they've been saying the same thing to us, that the cost of food, like steak, chicken, beef, are going way up. And the same thing with vegetables, and I mean, avocados are outrageous right now. I know we are all feeling it right now, but the thing I wanted to do is give you some perspective, because the way that bestplaces.net sets this up is they make an average and then say, if the United States average is 100, then if you're more expensive than the national average, your number is going to be above 100. And if you're less expensive, your number is going to be below 100. So that's how they give us these rankings. So according to bestplaces.net, groceries in Melbourne are 100.1. I definitely noticed our grocery bill went down about 15% when we moved here. So depending on where you are coming from, you may feel like your grocery bill has gone down like we did. I also wanted to talk about who the grocers are. Most people here will shop at Publix. It's a Florida-owned grocery chain. They are wonderful and very friendly there. We also have Costco, Winn-Dixie, Aldi's, and Fresh Market. We don't have a Whole Foods or Trader Joe's, just an FYI. At the time of this recording right now, it definitely feels like groceries have gotten super expensive. I love eggs, for example, and I get pasteurized ones. So I usually pay about $6 for a dozen at Winn-Dixie. They are $7 to $8 at Publix. But it is a little bit of a relief that we are right in line with the national average and not a lot higher like other cities in Florida can be. So the second thing on our list today is housing. Okay, so right now bestplaces.net is saying that Melbourne is 95. So we are 5 points below the national average. The current national median sales price, if we look at the United States, is $388,000 for a single family home. In Melbourne, Florida, it's $350,000. So we are slightly below that number in terms of the national average. So what I am telling you is you can live in warm weather year-round, live close to the beach, never have to shovel your driveway again, and live below the national average in terms of housing. So it's a no-brainer, right? Don't get me wrong, I'm not saying it's perfect, and you guys can check out my pros and cons. I go deep into that. But in my opinion, there are definitely lots of pros, and housing prices are one of them. And just keep in mind that if Melbourne is a little bit out of your price range, then you can find houses to be a little bit cheaper in the neighboring city, Bombay. The third thing on our list here is utilities. And what it's saying here on bestplaces.net is that Melbourne is below the national average in terms of cost for utilities. The number comes just in at 97.3 on the index here. So I was going to use my monthly bills as an example, but I'm probably not the best person because I love my house freezing. I actually asked a close friend of mine that has a family of four with a four bedroom house in Melbourne what her utility bills were. So on average, her bill for electricity monthly is $250. In the peak summer months, July, August, and September, it can be as high as $400. She said her water and sewer bill is $125 every month. Moving on to the Wi-Fi and phone bills, I'll use my own expenses for those. We use Spectrum for high-speed Wi-Fi, and that's $75 a month. And then we also pay $60 for two phone lines, which actually was a lot cheaper than we used to pay in Rhode Island. Look, in my experience, people's utilities vary greatly from person to person and house to house, because there's people who are like me who love their house freezing and other people who don't, for example. So it is a good idea to see where your current city stands on the index according to bestplaces.net and then compare it to our score and go from there. Okay, next is gas prices. So as of today, February 16th, 2023, gas prices in Melbourne are at $3.27 for regular. In New York, it's $3.56. Rhode Island is $3.35. And in California, it's $4.68. I will say, because I don't have a car, I don't have firsthand knowledge of public transportation, but I have heard it's not the most reliable here. So it's definitely a driving city here. Okay, moving on to the fifth and final cost, and probably the worst cost when it compares to the national average, and that is insurance, both home and auto. This is a big concern that a lot of people have moving into the area, and it's a valid concern. Now, because Melbourne is inland, you don't have to worry too much about insanely high insurance rates or being required to purchase flood insurance unless you want to live along the river or beachside. Insurance rates vary greatly here. For example, the lowest I have seen is about $1,200 a year for a new build, and I've seen insurance quotes as high as $7,000 a year for an older beachside home. So I always suggest shopping around insurance agencies and also looking for a property with a newer roof, PVC piping, and either impact windows or has shutters, because those things will help keep insurance premiums lower. I know the governor is also trying to work with insurance companies here, so I am hoping that insurance rates may become more affordable in the future, but for now, it can be pretty steep and should be something to budget for. Car insurance is also on the higher end here. For example, we had Geico in Rhode Island, and we've always had military plans, so our premiums may be a little less than what you have, but we paid $110 a month for two cars. In Florida, we use Progressive and we pay $235 a month for the two of us. So it pretty much doubled here. Well, there you have it, the cost of living in Melbourne, Florida. I hope this was helpful information for you and is useful in your decision to move here. Whenever I consider the higher cost of certain things, I remind myself that it's the cost of what I feel like is living in paradise. Warm weather year-round, palm trees, and living close to the beach. Make sure to comment below any questions you may have about living in Melbourne or anywhere in Brevard County. Thanks so much for watching. I'm Rachel Langley with Florida Lifestyle Realty, and I'll see you on the next one.